Welcome back, everyone, to the Cinematic Fanatics. We're watching episode four of...
Look, it's so different!
Yeah, it is kind of different. Episode four of Straw Rats.
Of War Star.
Straw Rats.
Episode four, A New Hope.
Be really dramatic, Ben.
Oh, so do you want me to do a funny one or just dramatic?
Do funny one, yeah.
Okay. It is a period of civil war. Abraham Lincoln and the rebel starships striking from a hidden base, also known as West Virginia, have won against their first victory and against the evil Galactic South. During the battle, rebel spies manage to steal secret plans to the Empire's ultimate weapon. It's ultimately a hot air balloon. The Death Star is what it's called. An armored space station with enough power to destroy an entire planet. Even though it has no armor, you can shoot off a bullet. Pursued by the Empire's sinister agents, Princess Leia Organa, or Skywalker, depending who you talk to, races home aboard her starship custodian, like my school, of the stolen plans that can save her people and restore freedom to the Union.
I would have loved it if you had kept it as Abraham Lincoln, but kept the Galactic Empire instead of the South. It's like it's actually against the Galactic Empire. And it's like, what? History.
History. I determine history now, not you.
Do you remember who directed this movie?
It's Jorge Lucas.
Jorge Lucas.
Abraham Lincoln's cousin.
Yes! Lincoln was the ultimate Jorge. Oh, it looks so different, and it sounds so weird. Man, this may have been... Like, the animation for this, was it done with, like, pencil? It kind of looks like a pencil art.
I think that's what they did or had to
It's do. Drawn, isn't it? Yeah! It looks so drawn.
I want to watch the original of what people saw in the theaters.
Oh, man, look at that. That's beautiful. It's like fireworks.
Boink. Good shot.
Oh, and those sound effects and lighting. Oh, it's so interesting.
Oh.
So old-fashioned.
Oh, man.
Oh. Hasn't aged very well, though. It kind of reminds me of Allegiant.
Don't even compare this. This is way better than Allegiant.
Oh, man. Well, the special effects remind me of Allegiant.
Movie that was made in, like, 2015 compared to, like, 78.
I know, right? It's really bad. Because, like, these bullets are just pictures that they animate by frame. You gotta think about that. It's pictures.
Like how they just casually walk across while a battle is happening.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely shouldn't shoot those guys.
Oh, man, look at that. That's glorious.
Whoa. So much smoke that wasn't
Yeah, these lasers are all added after the fact, of course. They're just pictures. Just like Allegiant had their gunfire. But I bet if we went frame by frame here, we would see that the lasers actually come out of the gun. Unlike Allegiant. iconic. I do have to appreciate it. I'm not a big fan of this trilogy. Like, this is probably my least favorite. Out of the entire... Yeah.
Okay. Mine goes... what is it? What's that?
This doesn't hold the same sentiment to me, though, as many other people have.
What do you mean? Like, people have a lot more...
Like, people who grew up with this.
Oh, yeah, like my dad, he loves these ones.
Yeah, there's such a strong sentimental value to it that it's important to you, therefore it's good.
I grew up with the prequels, not sequels. I grew up with the prequels, and that's why I love them so much. And also, they're just, like, joked to death.
I also grew up with the prequels.
But you as Star Wars as a whole just don't really, I mean, you find it okay, but...
As a whole, I prefer the newest ones. Which shows how much I love Star Wars, because it's only people who don't like Star Wars that much that like the new ones.
It's like I would say I'm a hardcore fan, it's the hardcore fans that don't like it.
Yeah. I'm not hardcore at all. I was just like, okay, these movies are pretty, so also, that's good for it.
This doesn't make sense. When you're being choked, you can't talk.
Oh, yeah. That is true.
Unless he's, like, gripping his cheekbones.
Yeah.
But he's not, so...
Oh!
Yeah, he just kind of killed him.
That's dark. Cool. Did you hear that sound? Yeah. He broke his neck. Collapsed his windpipe.
Alive.
The voice acting is interesting. Yeah. It doesn't sound like Anakin at all. It's funny.
So, it was so weird. So, the guy who's in the suit of Darth Vader...
I love how she has, like, cinnamon buns on both sides of her.
Uh-huh. I like,
There's one! Oh my gosh, awkward.
Shoots one person.
Oh, what? Oh, that's hilarious.
So I like
how... They just walk up to her casually, she's standing there. Yeah. Oh, there's one. bang.
So the body actor for Darth Vader, because it's not the same guy in the suit, is Scottish, and so he would say the lines. So Darth Vader was originally Scottish, and then in post-production, they just added in James Earl Jones' voice.
Aw, that's amazing. I could voice act one of these guys.
I always imagine when the music was going like this. It was doing like a wavy motion.
Oh, yeah. Like a hula dancer? Is that what you're imagining? Oh, yeah. No, it's not. It's okay. Just random sounds.
Okay, I was like, can we make fun of that?
How would it be racist?
I don't know.
Is it like...
Native Hawaiians? I don't know.
Oh, maybe.
Maybe. That's my question.
It's just me making random stupid sounds. It has nothing to do with Hawaiian culture.
We're naive. Exactly. So, we used to be naive.
Yeah, people are gonna, like, come up... This is going to be the thing that gets us canceled in
Now it's not even just me getting canceled.
Gabriel made weird sounds as he talked about Boromir hula dancing in a miniskirt. And we're like, ah, oh, dang it. Dang it. Dang it, publicity.
Dang it, publicity. No such thing as bad press.
Oh, yes, there is. people who say that are not good.
We're all covered in sand, too. How'd that get there?
Oh, no. This is the... Oh, they're trading with them, not attacking them.
Oh, this is where Bill Hader plays in the bad lip sync. It's Bill Hader plays Uncle Owen.
I didn't even think about this.
What?
What are the chances that Anakin's C-3PO droid
gets to...
Is in space. Is thrown away and ends up at Luke's
Tatooine. House. And, well, the coincidence that the Jawas even picked them up and then bring them...
Wow. That is insane.
It's so weird. So, like, you know the scene we watched of Great Gatsby?
Yes.
And it was so weird to... Because I haven't seen Spider-Man, but I knew he was Spider-Man before, and it was so weird to see him.
Oh, yeah.
As
Grew up with the Sam Raimi Spider-Mans. Was it was... I was okay with it. I like Tobey Maguire quite a bit.
I just couldn't take him seriously.
Hello there! Oh! Hey! Oh, no!
Oh, no! No! Pause!
Yeah, play.
Click it.
Yeah. Thank you. Alright, our computer with the Audacity stream almost died, and we're like, no! Because if it dies, we're done.
That was more than Darth Vader's. That was more motion than Darth Vader's now.
No!
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 I'm pretty certain when I originally made that voice, it was the Jerry Seinfeld
voice.
No! The B-movie! No!
No!
Welcome to the B movie.
I love that so much.
No. What if we made really bad jokes and puns about bees?
No.
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 That's what my producer said before I stabbed him.
No.
Now the B movie came out.
he made himself the executive producer.
I paid for it with the producer's money that I took after I killed him.
Kenobi.
No. That's what he said about the B movie.
Have you seen
that? But no, he's dead.
Time. I know you're just saying all those lines.
I'm gonna fall in love with a human girl.
Oh, he's not dead. Not yet.
Who?
You know him. Of course I know him. He's me. Sorry, I just kind of cut you off with the Jerry Seinfeld.
Oh, it's okay. No! I was done. No! I was done. Okay. I already went so many places. Hey, hey, Jerry, how's it going?
No!
No! Okay, that's fine. I was talking to Michelle, and it was like, that was the human girl!
Oh, okay.
I screwed your wife! I'm gonna frickin' kill you. I'm gonna frickin' kill you. Like the producer, I'm gonna frickin' kill you. Because I'm the frickin' president.
I just realized C-3PO is the
Transitions. Oh, dang it.
I just realized that C-3PO is the first Voldemort. He doesn't have a nose.
Oh, yeah. That makes him automatically Voldemort.
Yeah, if you don't have a nose, equals Voldemort.
I guess he's technically, like, he's still wearing something very similar to the thing he fought Luke with. I mean, Anakin with.
Yeah, because they're just, like, classic Jedi robes.
Yeah, that's interesting. Do you think they designed the Jedi robes off of this? Possibly.
I'm pretty sure. George Lucas did both.
Yeah. Do you think they knew ahead of time that was the traditional Jedi robe? Yes, because Luke wears something similar.
How did he... Oh, yeah. Well, Luke wears, like... That's why people were kind of like...
Yeah, that's very close.
They were like on Return of the Jedi because he's wearing all black and only Siths do that. And only Siths choke people. And they're like, is Luke turned to the dark side? And then he didn't.
People thought Rey was going to turn to the dark side and there would be another 3 movies. Did you know that? People thought there was going to be 12 Star Wars movies based off of the plot arc of the new trilogy. Which was clearly so amazing that it deserved 6 movies. There's probably going to be a new trilogy, Ben. I'm sorry, it just makes too much money.
Whoa!
Oh, man. Ah, the days.
Ah, the days.
The days. No!
Ah, no! The French.
Ah, the French. But if you... And you, if you ever get popped out at parties, you unpopular... Get Vita Vita Vegemite Muffin and you guys, man.
You guys,
one of my favorite things to do is like, you know, acetaminophen. That is really dark.
That's more dark than Anakin's death. Or Anakin's,
Oh my gosh. My goodness.
I'm pretty sure, yeah, they have like flamethroughers that just burn.
Holy crap! They're just skeletons now.
How did that. They didn't. That's not how.
And he seems.
That's not how decomposition works.
That. Like, if I really wanted to give a character, like, a really strong feeling that you can see he's having, do you know what I would have him do there?
What?
Have him throw up. That's a really good sign.
I mean, yeah.
I mean, you most people would throw up if your burned, parents were burned.
You're like, charred skeletons. Jeez.
Yeah. Yeah, the smell's in the air and people realize that, and then they throw up. It's a natural human thing, instead of him just being like, oh, no. My uncle and...
Yeah, I like how he just stares.
Look at my ball. It has a syringe on it. Oh, so scary.
This shot's going to tell you everything we need to know. This is for anti-vaxxers. The anti-vaxxers watch this movie.
That was really cool. Did you see
that? Oh, yeah, the camera.
Camera going down with the door and then moving up with the... That's something that I just did recently.
No, you're not.
These are not the droids.
You don't need to see his identity. Yep. I like how the other stormtroopers are okay with this.
They do this twice. They say these are not the droids you're looking for in the new trilogy.
Really?
Yeah, because BB-8. This is not the droid you're looking for. They do it twice! Man, Force Awakens sure was a nostalgia trip.
Exactly, I had a bad feeling about this.
They repeated so many things.
It had Carrie Fisher, it had Chewbacca, it had Han Solo, it had Luke Skywalker at the end.
That's ridiculous.
Send a scanning crew aboard. I want every part of this ship checked.
Yes, sir.
I sense something. A presence I've not felt since...
He walks away.
Oh my gosh!
He doesn't tell them anything. He's just like, it's mine.
I felt this presence...
and then he's gone. He's like, I haven't felt this presence since...
Walks there away. He goes. Yep. It instantly, there's no pause.
How can you even manage all that, like,
how do you,
smoke in
the air?
How
are you guys not dead?
Well, because all the
like,
smoke.
You're half exposed.
They're just, like, in the smoke. They can't see. That no one even sh- Oh, I guess he did.
There's no way.
Oh, yep, dead.
It goes straight, it goes straight into, like, a furnace.
Did you hear that yell? So I think it's the next scene is when we see the stormtrooper bonk his head.
What an incredible smell you've discovered. What?
Oh,
there's like an animal in here.
No, don't do that.
Oh my god.
Shoot.
Rick, okay.
What happened?
I don't know. Just let go of me and disappear.
But it's still in this room that has ankle deep water.
I was going to say, wait a minute.
Where did it go?
Is there a deeper part? this is the shallow end.
Weird.
Oh, they just said I got a fat bad feeling about this.
Yeah, I've seen Saw 5. It's not gonna happen, guys.
How many freaking Saws are there?
About 10, I think.
Are you kidding me?
No, there's currently 8.
I've only seen the last one.
What do you mean by the last one?
Jigsaw.
Oh, Jigsaw. Okay. There's multiple of the last ones.
What do you mean? Isn't it just Jigsaw ends the series?
No. Jigsaw is a new kind of remake franchise. there's seven original Saws.
I thought the Saw, like, villain, though, was his name was Jigsaw.
Yeah, but the original movies are called Saw.
Oh! There it is. Did you even hear the bonk?
Oh, I didn't? Let's go back and see if that was it.
Okay, look at the right.
That's brilliant. There was a sound effect in
there
everything.
There was. There was a bonk.
Didn't even notice it. What is this room for?
I guess to get somewhere. I mean, like, I think the bridge is like it like went into. I guess to close it off. Oh, goodbye.
Oh, Wilhelm scream. It is the first Wilhelm scream.
You even have that in Lord of the Rings. I forgot.
They have that in Lord of the Rings.
So it's when an elf, it's at Helm's Deep, and an elf like goes flying off, and he goes,
"Oh, that's right."
Yeah, so, like, when Yoda dies, he just dissipates like Obi-Wan. Yes. And so when they dissipate like that, they turn into Force Ghosts. That's why...
Oh, that's right, because it's meant to be a...
Yeah. What?
Trying to remember his name. Oh, it's a method that Qui-Gon learned.
So yeah, Qui-Gon...
That he shared with them.
So Qui-Gon didn't finish his studies in that, so that's why he doesn't burn when he's killed.
Yeah.
And that's the only reason why. That's why he doesn't disappear when he's killed.
So, the thing about people saying that, the reason that he's gone...
Yeah.
Is budget and censorship.
Yeah, because a lot of... Yeah, because he was just like, let's just do this cheap. But a lot of, like, fans... have come up with, like,
yeah,
oh, yeah,
a lot
this
of,
is why.
A lot of Star Wars fans try to explain things that don't need to be explained. Like Stormtrooper's bad aim. It's plot armor, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
That's why.
I like how the whole battle, he has to just tighten that the whole time. Like, you'll see, like, whenever it cuts to Darth Vader, he's just doing this.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just like, wow.
I'm turning up the volume on my headphones. Gotta listen to some Michael Bublé for no reason in particular.
I gotta hear the dog screeching with my TIE fighter.
It's a good Michael Bublé song.
What, dog screeching?
No, I was thinking... Like, I was trying to figure out what Darth Vader would be listening to, and I was like, Michael Bublé. Bublé,
Darth
sorry.
Vader would listen to, like... George Lucas goes to John Williams, so we want you to imagine what the people would be hearing in this scenario. and then he comes up with his actual music.
Yeah.
Have you seen... See, doing it again. I was gonna tighten that bolt that's loose. Oh, that's it.
Going, that's going. A lot less high-tech than we've seen in this prequel. No! Bad to the bone. He's not even listening to with the lyrics. He's just listening to the instrumental.
Gold fired red leader.
Gold leader, do you have any more chocolate? Dang it! I wanted some after the fight was over. The Imperials got all the chocolate on their vests.
I like how they recognize there's a danger. I think you overestimate their chances. I like how he's like, there's a danger. And I was like, why don't you block it up then?
Oh, so the whole Death Star explodes. What about everybody on it? Like, the whole city of people.
Tarkin dies in this. Darth Vader is the only one who really survives. Yeah, you don't see him anymore in this series.
What?
That's why they had to he's not in it anymore. That's why they CGI'd him for, like, because he'd be alive then, but he wouldn't be alive after A New Hope. Music pointing in the back.
Most people, when they say OG, they don't know that it stands for Original Gangsta.
I remember that, yeah, I knew that
I looked it up, and it's specifically Original Gangsta.
Oh,
not gangster?
Gangster.
Not it's
gangster.
Not even gangster.
Wow.
You're supposed to say gangsta, which is really funny to me, since it's like an official definition site for
it.
Wow. Yes, he's gonna be several fine pots.
It would be
and
way
pans.
It'd be way more like cheap to like just get a new one than have to like.
But they have that one. He has a personality, so there's sentimental quality to it.
Those guards can't see.
Oh, I was doing the wedding march. What were you doing? Sorry.
This is music.
The only survivors of our attack on the Death Star We should definitely be celebrating right now.
I mean, I am. I'm just like, just slapping my knees.
Like, I'm thinking, if you send out a full army and only technically two come back and one of them wasn't even a part of the army.
I mean, look at all those pilots they have. Look how many they didn't use.
I know, right? Why didn't they send everybody after the Death Star?
That was like, if they did that, the game it would be over.
Like, the chances would be so much better if they sent more than five people.
The rebellion would be over because the Death Star would have blown up the planet, and then the movies would be over.
Well, it would have been more likely for them to win if they sent more people.
Exactly.
And the rest of the rebels are on the planet, so they're gonna die if those five don't make it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Just send everybody. And apparently she's the princess of the rebellion now or something?
She's the leader.
She is?
Yeah, she's
How'd she rise to that power?
Because her father was the leader and then he died and she took over.
But her father...
Yeah, he was the galactic senator.
I guess so.
In the Empire. I like how Chewbacca doesn't get a medal.
Yes! Your friends are all dead, except these guys.
Yeah.
Yay!
A force user, a brother to leader.
A guy who is like, I don't want to fight.
And a guy who is like,
that's
I'm leaving.
That's where it ends? Seriously?
Yeah, that's the final.
Wow, okay. Directed by Jorge Lucas.
Gary Kurtz.
cool. We have completed week four of our Wars nonology.
I like how it's week four, but we've literally just...
Yeah. Star Wars is a nonology now.
A nonology?
That means nine.
Yeah.
Because
there's Guinness.
Yeah.
Like Guinness Irish beer.
All right. Well, thank you, Agus, for watching. Please like and subscribe and share this video if you love Star Wars. If you love Star Trek, share this video.
We should watch the first episode of Next Generation.
Oh, that would be fun. It is technically a movie.
Because it's an hour, yeah.
Yeah. All right. Bye, everyone.
Bye. Goodbye.